blow it off good.
Make sure I get all the dust out of the little nooks and crannies. And I don't know if you can see or not, but that stand that the head's on that's covered in paper. Basically, the paint job's only going to be as clean as the surfaces you're working off of. It's kind of like you wouldn't want to eat a meal off of a dirty plate. And so you don't really want to paint off of a dirty stain. And so you put something on there to block that dirt. You're never going to get all the paint and the buildup from all the years of using these stands. They're going to be built up. So you're blocking it with paper and tape. Wipe it down. Water-based cleaner is going to get all the dust off of it and all of the organic oils. So organic would be anything that's natural. And then I'll wipe it down with a solvent-based cleaner. That's going to get all the petroleum-based contamination off heavy things that are like greases, not natural substances. That's kind of like a rudimentary way of putting it. But spray it on the inside because I don't want it getting down in behind those chocks. Oh, I was telling you about the stand being paper. There you go. Give it a little better vantage point when I'm talking about there. I just realized it's not in the framework of the camera. This blower right here, it gives a little bit different pattern than, say, a pencil type blower. You got the pencil type blower right here. There are pencil type blower. This type of blower is my preferred blower before I paint. It more mimics the air pattern that comes out of the spray gun. So it'll kind of loosen up whatever that would naturally loosen up. Although the pencil blower is going to loosen up the most, but this is just a real good extra step. All right, ready to base. I'm going to spray the first coat on. It's probably going to look pretty orange peely at first because I'm not going to put any reducer in my base coat. I'm just going to spray it straight. And the reason for that is I do have a little bit of wood grain there, so I just want to make sure I put something nice and thick over it. Now ultimately I'm going to stencil it over, I'm going to sand it, I'm going to clear it, I'm going to do a lot of different things, so it's not important to me right now that it be perfectly slick.
based in black. Nothing else has happened besides that. Take a quick look at it. Let it flash off for, you know, like 20, 30 minutes. Then we can either clear it or start stenciling it. I haven't decided which one I'm gonna do yet. But that is where I'm at with it. In case I don't get any further today. All right. We'll leave it at that for right now. All right, the base is kicked off about 20 minutes or so. What I'm gonna start doing now is just masking it off. So I wanna mask off anything I don't wanna get overspray on. Obviously, the stencils are only gonna mask off so much. So I wanna kinda block the top and the back and just expose the sides of the head. I'm gonna do the head first. I've got a piece of tape that I put behind this lock so the color doesn't just blow through there. So that's what I'll do first. I want to tape it off in a way to where I can just change the side stencils out without having to remask everything again. This head in two. It's not too bad to tape off. The Bally solid state heads are a pain in the ass to tape off because they have that kind of framed face. Now these get done in different order. The head gets red first, I think, and white second. The lower gets white second and red. The lower gets white first and red second. So they're reversed. So I'm just gonna get the red on here. Let me get the stencil. I'm just gonna lock the back of it and the top. In the back and the top, that I know that on the other side I want to do the same thing. All right, let's spray some red.
can, because generally speaking, the sooner I get it off here, the less likely I'm going to have glue residue. It's not to say I definitely won't, but I still have it. Less likely. No problems there. It looks good. I'm seeing glue residue. Now, where I'm very likely to pick it up is going to be on the next round, but I got to continue on because once these X's are in place, you know, what I'd love to do is just peel the X's off there, clear the head, and then if I put the white on there and have any issues, then I can just wipe it off. It won't mess up anything that I've done previously, but the issue with that is, like I said, you lose the X's. In the past, I've done things to kind of mark where the X's were and try it that way, but then you have to come back and circle back around and airbrush back over that. So you're really just moving your work around. It's still having to repaint when we look at it. So let this set for a few minutes. I just put a couple light coats on there because I don't want to have any really hard edges. It's going to have some anyway, but we'll deal with those later. But there's that. All right, let's put the white stencil on. So basically just want to align this X within this box, this cutout right here. Kind of move fast because the longer these set on here, the more likely I'm going to get glue residue left behind to deal with. I think they should make these out of something else personally. I think what is this? This is 811. Thinking like maybe 813, something like that, but it might be that things are harder to weed or cut. So what might work better for the kind of paint I use might be harder to deal with for the person that makes them. So I'm always trying to adapt what we can get to what I do. Can be a challenge. go. So you see how clean that looks. I don't know how well it shows in here. It's a little bit dark sometimes. But it has a really clean look to it that you wouldn't really get with the aged white. The aged white would just kind of make it look dingy. So I like that pop, how it has, you know, basically it almost makes it look 3D. All right, cool. So the head's done. I'll unmask the entire portion of the head, put it to the side, and we'll start dealing with the lower